just hate it when I can't find anything to watch on YouTube. It drives me crazy because I'm lazy and I'd rather sit back and watch someone else's hard work instead of having to do it myself. I'm telling you, I'm watching Alan Watts there and I just said, it doesn't have the urgency of the times. We are in a time of this incredible convergence that is overwhelming our psyche. And the remedy is what? We have to have no psyche. That is the remedy. No psyche is the remedy. How do we get no psyche? Okay, we have to find out the answer to this immediately. So I have to dig to pull this out of obscurity. We have to look at this very carefully. We hear the term Christ self, the gift of Christ to us. What is this gift of Christ to us? We know it solves something. It's important. Christ is the quote-unquote our perfect future self. It is a perfect self the Holy Spirit has for us, actually. Now, this perfect self does not have a psyche. When the question is asked, who is it? What is it that knows no self? What is it that knows no self? We're not going to no self, okay? We're going to the perfect self. Now, what is the reaction to perfect self? Well, here's a way to look at it. We trade in a hypothetical, plausible attempt to attain a self. Exchange it for a perfect self. Now, the perfect self, we call it Christ within us. The perfect self is within us. That perfect self does not have a psyche. It does not have any reaction to what it is. It is what it is. It is perfect. It is happy with what it is. It is perfectly happy with what it is. That's why it's in a state of bliss continuously. So that is our self now. So we trade in no self for a perfect self. See, right now, we're attempting to attain a future self. That has been our position for so long. So the Holy Spirit says, okay, because of the continuity issue, I'll give you a future self. But that future self is perfect. All right? Perfect. And it wasn't attained through time or through suffering or sorrow or attainment of any kind and learning, whatever. It's perfect. So here is your future self. So you trade in an imaginary, never-to-be self that we're trying to attain. Actually, it's the power of death is what we're trying to attain. That's a little secret that no one wants to admit. But it's true. But we're really trying to attain. The ego tells us we're trying to attain a self. We're not. We're trying to attain a way to destroy reality, destroy the self, as it were, the self of reality, the holy self, the holy oneness of reality. We're trying to destroy it. So we're really not after self, really, but we have thought of it in this way to sort of camouflage it. So we're so used to this, the Holy Spirit says, okay, let's have a perfect self, that which cannot be destroyed or harmed in any way. So we will feel as if, hey, I have this viewpoint. I have a viewpoint on existence. I have a viewpoint. A self means a perspective, a viewpoint. We're trying to obtain a viewpoint of death, of annihilation. We want to feel that reality can be annihilated. That's the viewpoint we're searching for. We can never find that. But we can find a viewpoint that shows us that reality cannot be annihilated. That is the Christ self that is a gift to us, a gift of grace to us from God through the creation of the Holy Spirit. So we all have this Christ self within us, this perfect future self with a viewpoint on reality. Reality cannot be destroyed. A viewpoint on existence saying no, you can't succeed. Perfect no. That's a viewpoint. Okay? It's therefore a self But the self is not reacting to this viewpoint. It's steady. It is steady. So it's called bliss. The mental makeup, the psyche of this perfect self that we have, this Christ self, is bliss. There is nothing else going on. So by accepting this Christ within us now, this perfect viewpoint of no upon the attempts to bring death to reality, saying it's impossible, it'll never happen, bliss, steady state bliss, then all of this convergence that is overwhelming our psyche now has no effect upon us, has no effect on our new self. Jesus said you must be born again, meaning you must attain a new viewpoint. You must accept a new viewpoint from grace. It's not something that you earn through effort. It's something that is given to us as a gift. It's already there. Everyone has it. Accept that, and there is no overwhelming because the psyche is steady. Perfect no. No oscillations, no doubts, nothing kicking around there. It's beautifully, serenely, effortlessly steady state. Neutral, vision of neutrality, vision of stalemate, vision of perfect no, vision of the seamless oneness of this perfect no. No, we cannot ever die to what we are. And then the times will not overwhelm us. You see? It will not. We will not have any reaction to what we are, because we simply are a point of view of perfect no. There's nothing else to react to it within our psyche, that psyche. It knows that no is known. Okay, no is known. So really that's the remedy. And this has to be brought forward with urgency, because we're in the time of convergence. Okay, I say that we're in the time of convergence. This is a time of convergence, which is designed to overwhelm our psyche. And a lot of us are feeling this. We're saying, oh, wait a minute. There's some kind of conscious blueprint, some conspiracy to overwhelm our psyches at this time. And there is. There's no question about it. And you may be feeling the jitters. You may be feeling the anxiety. You may be feeling that your spirit is very disturbed. Something, wow, something's really coming. It's the convergence that is coming. From all angles, so many, many angles, it's all converging, and we're just like going, wow, this is just decimating us. This is collapsing us. This is getting our psyche just to be boiling, just boiling. So the answer is what? No psyche. No psyche, so to speak. Or steady state psyche, which, you know, is almost the same as saying no psyche, really. Because we think of psyche as something that is in flux. The steady state psyche is not in flux. The bliss of nirvana, nirguna, samadhi, Christ consciousness, oneness consciousness, etc. That is what is needed. And we don't have time to fool around in some academic way with this, some scientific, academic, whatever, that lacks the urgency of the times. Because you get all these talking heads and blah, 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 blah. Where is the urgency? Because we are in the time of convergence right now. Right now, this very second, we are in the times of convergence. For goodness sakes, what is wrong with people who are acting like they, you know, there's nothing, we're in, let's waste some more time, you know, instead of getting down to it. What is that? That's a recipe for being overwhelmed, okay? And they may not admit to being overwhelmed, but their actions will betray the fact that they have been overwhelmed. So we don't want a psyche that is in the making. We want a perfect psyche, okay? A perfect psyche that knows the no. That is what we have to have. And traditionally in Western, we call it Christ consciousness. Okay, Christ consciousness is what we need. Christ consciousness. The symbol of Christ, Christ means oil, or anointed one, with oil. The ancients anointed stuff with oil because it was a preservative, and stuff didn't decay as quickly when you anointed it. So this terminology, Christ, is the anointed one, that which is anointed. It's like a psyche that's been anointed with oil, that it doesn't deteriorate, it doesn't decay. And the oil is a seamless thing, okay? It's a seamless anointing of seamlessness upon, quote-unquote, the psyche. This is just a way of talking about it. Other traditions can use different terminology. It's all pointing to the same thing. It's all pointing to the very same situation. And we have to get to this. We have to accept this psyche, as it were, the perfect psyche. The anointed psyche. We have to accept it. Otherwise, we're going to be overwhelmed. We're going to be overwhelmed, no question about it. And then we're going to act out in strange ways. Self-destructive ways, actually. I'm telling you, there is definitely a plot, a blueprint to bring this about. This has been known for a long time. And people start disintegrating, and they start clutching at straws, and they scatter to the four winds, you know, gone with the breeze. But we don't have to succumb to that. We don't have to succumb to it. So, how do we get this acceptance to happen? Is the question. We have to dig into that. I always said, hey, we need a heavyweight here. We need something that really can trigger the acceptance in us. But we can't sit around holding our breath for that, unfortunately. It's too late for that. To hold our breath, I mean, it needs to happen now. It's important to realize that this psyche takes no time. It's not something that's developed or attained. Therefore, no time is needed for this point of view to be within us. It's complete, already complete within us. It doesn't depend on time. It was complete from the very beginning. It's the perfect no. No, we can't. No, we can't. We can't die to what we are. That is simply all it is. No, we can't. This perfect no. No, we can't. This is the Christ within us. If we do this mantra, no, we can't. No, we can't. No, we can't. We're sort of allowing ourselves to... We're making room at the end for this Christ consciousness, which is what we have to have. It's not a question. It's not an elective. It's an imperative. Otherwise, we're going to fragment and disintegrate, and those who try to keep it all together, such as myself, are going to be, you know, collapsed, just energetically collapsed by the overload. It's an overload. You overload a circuit, you're going to trip the circuit breaker. And you know, we wonder, what's going on in the world? What are they really after? I mean, I'll tell you, it's overload is what they're after, actually. You may think like that they have some incredible plot and I can't quite figure it out. The plot is to overload us from all different angles. So we just say, oh, we go into the state of apathy and really depression and despair and just overload. It's an overloaded state. And people will just feel like they just can't muster up, you know, anything that just kind of become very... fun, basic kind of survival stuff, you know, eating and sleeping and just going to work, watching, you know, television and go to, you know, some wine festival and you know, giggle and laugh, and that's about it. That's overload. They don't have answers. They don't even have questions. They just can't do it. And most of the world is overloaded already. They just can't muster the effort needed. And for those of us who still are making the effort, you know, we're feeling the pressure of this overload. So, no, we can't. No, we can't. No, we can't. No, we can't. The perfect no. And the perfect no has a stable psyche. And we can, that can be ourself. That is the self that we are told we it's a gift of God, and we can accept that this is ourself instead of exchange it for this process that we call a self, which is really just a process to try to attain a power of death over the one self. So we just trade this process, which can never succeed, for this perfect no, stable Christ consciousness, stability. So it's not that difficult if someone can really, like a laser, focus our attention on it. I'm just a 10%er. I mean, I'm just making the effort here. But it would be great if there was just this laser-like, absolute, adamant, clear focus on this very issue. Just that's it, you know. And then we could say, yeah, and that would like help our 10% grow into 100%, or at least 51%. So we say, okay, this is what I choose right now. So it's a race against time. We're really in a race against time right now. We're in a race against the overload. We're in a race against all this convergence that's designed to overload our circuits. And I'm telling you, I've just about had enough. Can't take very much more. Because it's coming from all angles. You name it, right? You name it. All this places where we've gone for psychic stability is now just crumbling into instability. The entire facade is just crumbling. And that's going to lead us dazed and confused. And our psyches just won't work. We're just, helpless. We just can't get the escape velocity necessary. So we have to bring, quote unquote, Christ, the anointed psyche, into the picture. You know, forget about religion. Forget about everything except that this is within us, this anointed psyche, the perfect no, anointed with the perfect no, is within us. We have to have that faith. And we have to have the faith that, yes, this anointed psyche can be our functional self now, can be our functional self here. And actually, it's the height of functionality because it doesn't collapse from the overload. What could be more functional than that? Because we're heading right now toward non-functionality, as a matter of fact. That's what I feel. I feel in myself this tremendous sense of impending non-functionality, really. And so we need to exchange that non-functionality for this beautiful, flawless functionality of the anointed psyche. Call it Christ. It really, in practical terms, it's the anointed psyche, the anointed self. The anointed psyche is, I think, a more pragmatic term to use. And I know there's a lot of people in the world that are kind of put off by religion and religious terms, etc. That's fine. That doesn't bother me at all. So use the term, the anointed psyche. The psyche anointed with the perfect no, which is the Holy Spirit saying to our dreams of annihilation, saying, no, you can't. No, you can't. You cannot annihilate. You cannot die to what you are. You cannot die. What you are can never die. What we are can never die. We are eternal life created by the prime creator. We can never die. And the Holy Spirit is adamant about that, and has this adamancy of the Holy Spirit is translated for us into this anointed psyche we call the Christ within us, or the anointed psyche that is totally stable. Totally stable. It is in this perfect no. No, we can't. And that psyche, we can then use that as our functionality in this world. And we're be very calm, very blissful. Nothing bothers us, really. We can't be overloaded. We cannot be overloaded. So we think right now that we're suffering from a couple issues. The debt crisis. This crisis. We think, oh, there's some crises here that we're suffering from. No, not really. It's a trick. It's a trap. We're suffering from the totality of all these issues in the world, so many, many, many things converging, so much. It's the totality of it all that we're really suffering from. And our psyche in it, we're seeing it all over the world, that there's this loss of the sharp edge of discernment throughout the world. That is what I've been noticing. It just simply isn't there anymore. Very, very few have it. There are some that watch these videos that I can tell they still have it. But they're under pressure, under duress. They're feeling like, wow, this is so difficult to keep that sharp, the edge sharp. Everything's dulling it down. I'm getting duller and duller and duller. You know, it's a bad situation. So don't get trapped into thinking that I have to figure out this crisis or this issue. Forget it. It's the totality of all the issues is producing the overload, which is dulling us down. So, and our psyche is getting overwhelmed by this, okay? So we need, quote unquote, no psyche. The psyche that is no psyche. The stable psyche, the anointed psyche. And if you want to put it in classical religious terms, the Christ child, okay? The Christ child within us. And I know that there is this anointed psyche, quote unquote, Christ child within us, because I've experienced it. So I know for sure that it is there. On several instances, I have directly experienced it within me. It is there for sure. And we just simply have to say, okay, this is my functioning here. This is my functionality here. My function is not to melt down and collapse, have my psyche overwhelmed and collapsed. My function here is to be calm and peaceful and blissful and have this perfect stability of psyche here. That is my function. This is the big struggle. This is the separating of the wheat from the tares, the noxious weeds, as it were. As the psyche melts down, it turns into a noxious weed. So, I wish there was more videos on YouTube. I wish I could, but that really, you know, has this sense of urgency and just laser-like, you know, is right on it, right now. Because then I'd be watching them. And I would prefer to be watching those. I prefer to watch someone who's making better videos than this. Absolutely. Absolutely. I always prefer the best. And, so, I just hope that there is such a thing. Because then I could do that. I wouldn't have to spend my time doing this. You know, it's a great effort on my part to do this. And but I can't just sit back and watch this stuff because it's driving me crazy. It doesn't have the escape velocity that we need right now because it's on us. The convergence is upon us. Okay? The overload is upon us right now. And we have to get this anointed psyche right now. So can't hold back. Got to tell it like it is here. Put this up on YouTube, and hopefully there are those who it'll resonate with you, and it'll help keep the sharpness there. And you can say, hey, yeah, hey, it is possible. Yeah, this is it. I can see this can take place. This can take place. And maybe there's somebody out there who's going to do it, actually. Yeah, why not? Why not? Why not? Why not? Why not? And put a video up and say, yeah, I've done it. I've made the exchange. It's a piece of cake. The psyche is not reacting to itself having succeeded. It's always... The term success is meaningless to it. It's always been in this stable state, the perfect no. It's always been seen as perfect no. So it's not going to say, hey, I'm enlightened, or whoopee. No, you enter into the stable state where enlightenment has always been the case. It's not an enlightenment of some psyche. It's entering into what's always been the case. That this perfect psyche, this anointed psyche, has always been this way, always will be. And you don't go back to the old psyche, which is just a process of trying to find the death of reality. And you don't go back, hey, okay, now how does it feel now? Well, it's not going to understand or be aware at all. It's It's a moot question, really. It's a moot question. How does instability feel about stability? Instability has no idea about stability. It can't feel it. It can't feel it. So asking how do you feel about it, it's not going to be a stable answer. It can't give you an answer of stability. So it's a futile question. Asking questions of our psyche right now, the search for a psyche, the search for death really, is futile because it has no answer. It has no stability. It's always saying, well, I don't have it yet. I'm searching for it. But whereas the anointed psyche is the answer. It's not searching, it is the answer. It's the perfect no. It's the vision of neutrality, everything right now, nothing has to happen. Nothing has to happen because it's always been no. We cannot die to what we are. So it doesn't matter what's happened, it's all equally meaningless. We can see it all as completely neutral. So, what more can be said? What more can be said? It's the spirit of urgency that is important right now. And how can this happen? I guess we just have to keep on praying, keep on focusing, keep on inquiring, keep on looking. Satsang inquiry means looking. Keep on looking at the answer. Keep looking in the direction of the answer. The anointed psyche. Okay, this is something I believe that everybody can accept. We can get past beyond all the sectarianism, okay, out there in the world. This is truly ecumenical of saying the anointed psyche, anointed with the perfect no. This is something, again, that I feel that everybody from whatever background can kind of relate to. And we get past all the other stuff because we don't have any more time to waste on quibbles. Okay? No more time on quibbles. It's finished. We are finished with quibbles. Completely finished. We don't have any more time for that. So, the anointed psyche. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. All right.